Hey everyone, my name is Tyler, and today we're going to go over the appropriate use criteria for PSMA PET imaging. The Society of Nuclear Medicine this past week came out with a new set of criteria or guidelines on appropriate use, so I just wanted to bring this to you. Financial disclosures, I have no financial disclosures. References for today, I use the Society of Nuclear Medicine website. If you look down in the description below, you'll see these links. The first one is the actual website where everything's located. The second one is the PDF location. So you can click that, download it yourself. Why develop the criteria? Well, first, the purpose of this document is to describe the appropriate use criteria for PSMA imaging for prostate cancer. The second is to improve healthcare outcomes for the intended patient pop while helping decrease unnecessary imaging costs for the patient. Okay, so first, who developed these criteria? The Society of Nuclear Medicine, the American College of Nuclear Medicine, the American Urology Association, the Australian and New Zealand Society of Nuclear Medicine, and the American Society of Clinical Oncology. So there is several groups that had their hand in developing this criteria. So it's not just one, but a handful of different groups. Now, right now, there's two radiopharmaceuticals that are FDA approved for PSMA imaging. Which one should we use? First, there's gallium-68 PSMA, and there is F-18. And so, what do they say about this? Which radiopharmaceutical should we use? Well, there are many small differences between each radiopharmaceutical. There is no evidence to date that their diagnostic performance differs. For the purpose of this AUC document, all PSMA PET radiotracers are treated as equivalent and are referred to as a class. So they don't say one is better than the other. They actually say that they're about the same. The methodology, the process of the appropriate use criteria developed was modeled after the RAND and UCLA appropriateness method for AUC development. It includes multi-stakeholder identification of a list of relevant clinical scenarios, a systematic review of evidence in the literature, and a systematic synthesis of the available evidence, while adhering to the Institute of Medicine standards of development, trustworthy clinical guidance. That's how they came up with that. Now they came up with a rating or a scoring system that and it shows if it's appropriate or not. So first, if it comes with a score between a 7 and a 9, that is considered clinically appropriate to do the exam. If it comes to a 4 to a 6, this may be appropriate to order the exam. If it scored a 1 to a 3, it's actually rarely appropriate and probably shouldn't do it, except in the rare cases where it is absolutely necessary. So scenario number one, a patient with suspected prostate cancer evaluated for targeted biopsy and detection of an intraprostatic tumor. The patient has a high or rising PSA with an abnormal digital rectal exam. So this actually scores a 3, which is rarely appropriate. Typically what they'll probably do in this case is do the biopsy because this patient has not actually been diagnosed with prostate cancer yet. So rarely appropriate in this scenario. Scenario number two. Patient with very low, favorable, or intermediate risk prostate cancer. This actually falls at a number 2, which is rarely appropriate. Scenario number 3, newly diagnosed unfavorable, intermediate, high risk, or very high risk prostate cancer. This scores a number 8, which is appropriate. Scenario number 4, a newly diagnosed unfavorable, intermediate, high risk, or very high risk prostate cancer with negative or equivocal disease on conventional imaging. This is scores number 8 and is appropriate. Real quick, if you have a newly diagnosed prostate cancer and all of your exams are negative, that really kind of makes you wonder if the imaging is just missing the prostate cancer. Is it too early, or was, you know, any kind of surgery or previous treatment, was it completely successful? You just don't know. This PSMA does a really good job at finding any kind of metastatic disease or leftover tissue in the prostate bed. So, scenario number five, a newly diagnosed prostate cancer with widespread metastatic disease on conventional imaging. This scores a number four, which may be appropriate. And the reason is, if you already know there's widespread metastatic disease using just the standard CT, MRI, bone scan, then this is not going to tell you much more information. You may find new lesions that are smaller and harder to find, but it probably would not impact the clinical outcome or any kind of treatment. You'd probably do the exact same. So scoring number four, this may be appropriate. Scenario number six, persistent or PSA rise from undetectable level after a radical prostatectomy. This is a number nine. So this is one of the highest that you can get. If you've had a radical prostatectomy and your PSA does not go down, that's highly suspicious. Also, if you have a PSA rise from a zero to whatever threshold level do you decide to go off of. But if you have a prostatectomy and your PSAs go down to zero and then they start coming back up, that's highly suspicious for a recurrence. And it's very appropriate to do this exam. Scenario number seven, a PSA rise above the nadir value after radiotherapy. Appropriate is a nine. So this is very appropriate to do the exam if your PSA rises above the nadir value after radiotherapy. Scenario number eight, PSA rise after focal therapy of the primary tumor. This actually scores a number five, which may be appropriate. There are several different focal therapies that you can do now with prostate cancer, but a rise after a focal therapy only may be appropriate in some cases. Scenario number nine, non-metastatic castrate-resistant prostate cancer, that's the M0 status on conventional imaging. So this is the suspected recurrence without visualization on imaging or conventional imaging. So do you suspect a recurrence, but your CTs, bone scans, MRIs are all negative? Let's see here. So the appropriateness is a 7. It is appropriate. And that is because you really suspect that there is some type of disease and you're just not seeing it. And that's when this exam is appropriate. Scenario number 10, post-treatment PSA rise in a metastatic castrate-resistant prostate cancer patient. The score is a number 6. This may be appropriate in some cases, just because post-treatment PSA rise is pretty typical and doesn't cause a ton of red flags, but it may be appropriate in the right clinical setting. Okay, this is the last scenario we're going to go over today, the evaluation of treatment response. So this scores a number 5, which may be appropriate in some cases. If the patient is having difficulty with chemo or radiation therapy, it might be beneficial to evaluate treatment response. If there is some sort of positive treatment response, then it might be worth the patient kind of pushing through those hardships. But this does score number 5, so it may be appropriate in some clinical scenario. Okay, this is the actual chart that the societies and different groups put together. We just went through all these different scenarios, the ratings and the scores. Here is the actual full document. Again, if you look in the description, you can click one of the links there and it'll bring you to the website or pull up this PDF file for you. References. Again, I went through the Society of Nuclear Medicine. That is, right there's the link. That's the website to their main page. Okay, that about does it for us. If you have any questions, go down in the comments section and fill those out. I'll go in and answer anything that you put in there to the best of my ability. Also, you can shoot me an email at tyler@medical-imagingconsultants.com. If you think of any other topics you'd like to hear more information about, please let me know. I'll be happy to do everything I can. If not, until next time, hit that like, subscribe button, and thank you for listening.